Hi there. Well, it is Saturday, August 3rd, I believe, 2013. It's been a long time since I've done a video, and I just this second thought to myself, knowing me, knowing that I don't have anything planned as usual, if y'all know me and have been watching my videos. So I decided just at the last second that these videos for me right now, until I do get a plan, the plan is that this is really good therapy for me, okay? And I'm just so glad to say hi to you and see what comes out of my heart and mouth today. There's an airport right nearby, so you may be hearing some airplanes. I'm nearby the Palomar Airport. Forget the official name of it up here in Carlsbad. So just getting ready to go into 24-hour fitness sports here on Palomar Airport. But anyway, so praise God, and then I got my my cell phone over here whistling at me with little noises for notifications and stuff. So boy, anyway, so well, praise God, everything's basically good. Been through a rough week though, a rough day or so ago. I was just basically shocked out of my pants when I was just minding my own business, and I'm not going to go into the details, I don't think, hopefully. I'll go into some details, but I was doing just a normal thing, basically not hurting anybody, just kind of minding my own business. I was at work, and my work allows a variation of various things that I can do there, and one of them is I can turn the TV on if I want to. So I mean, everybody else does it, and it's not a thing where, well, everybody else does it, does that mean that you have to do it? Yeah, I can do it, okay? It's not excuse me, it wasn't about that, and I have forgiven this lady. I have forgiven her, but the point is that I'm going to share a few things out of my heart today about that, I believe, because it was such a shocker to me. Another professing Christian decided to let me know that it was the atmosphere of having the news on coming out of the TV. That was the point she was trying to make, was is that it's creating an atmosphere. Okay, well, I'm sorry, but oh my God, I was shocked. Okay, so then later I faced the fire and really stood up for myself, so to speak. But she still didn't get it. Bless her heart, I have forgiven her, but she just still didn't get it. As an American, I have a right to really just watch. I mean, I'm not watching porn. I wasn't watching porn. I was watching the news, okay? But she had a problem with it as a Christian, that it was creating an atmosphere in the house. And we're at work, okay? We're not there to preach Jesus. We're not there to, we're there to work, and we get paid for our job at work. And I understand where she was coming from. So I let her know that I was a prayer warrior, and that I do pray. It wasn't that I had the news on because I was trying to fish for news. I get all my news mostly online, okay, before even a lot of the networks get their news. Quite a few times I'll get it faster than they do. But the point is that, so she thought because I'm a prayer warrior, then it was okay that I was watching TV news. Because we have the TV on all the time watching shows and even violent shows and movies and NCIS, etc. But because I was watching the news, she had a problem with that, okay? Now, so anyway, praise God, it kicked me into a different gear. It kicked me into a different gear where when I first came there, I was free in so many ways, even though I was homeless for 8 days. But this freedom I have, the freedom that I had before I decided to get settled in to where maybe I could sit down and watch TV or get settled in and have a Christian, nice Christian sister, friend, blah, 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 blah. You know what? Forget it. Forget it, okay? It set me free. So now I can go out and I can get out of the house and I can do my work and I can be free and, you know, just please, okay? My goodness. And then I was on in the internet last night, and you know, when you have your own Facebook thread going, and then people come into it and they decide to give their opinion, you know, it's one thing giving your opinion and that's okay, but when you start accusing the person that owns the Facebook page or profile and you start a fight with that person, it's time to remove your ass from that thread. Okay, now I'm talking to Christians, okay? I'm talking to professing Christians today, I guess. I'm just really like, no wonder people don't want to go to church. No wonder people don't like Christians, okay? Now, you may not like me because I'm this or that, and that's fine. I turned off my comments on YouTube because I had such nonsense for comments on there. It was throwing me off to where, and I may turn them off because I'm getting them privately. So you have free speech, but then again, if you're going to throw me off of my message or whatever I'm trying to do on here, or just get on here and act like a crazy person, or just get on here and use this as therapy, and keep in mind the audio on here may not be correct at times. It may go very slow and I may sound like the devil talking like that. Anyway, so then I get frustrated too when I try to post these YouTube videos on Facebook and nobody watches them. So anyway, I got to get over that, you know, which I am. I'm really getting over it, actually. I deal with my own problems, you see. People need to really respect other people. And if we have issues with our president, you need to allow us to have issues with our president. Can you look back and you think about Hitler? Now, I'm not saying Obama is Hitler. He could be worse, okay? He could be worse in so many ways. Yet, you know, we know he's not going to be, you know, hopefully killing people. But anyway, like Hitler did. But I'm just saying, back then, when Hitler was doing what he was doing, don't you wish people would have had the right to stand up and speak? You know, as Christians, we had better wake up. And I really appreciate Steve Sanchez so much because he comes right out on the radio and he calls pastors on it. We're not coming against pastors. We're not coming against Christians. We're not coming against you, whoever you are, that has a different opinion about things than we do. We're not coming against you, okay? So don't come against us, okay? But really, let's all have some free speech here. And I need to talk about anger in the home. If you're a professing Christian and you are you have an attitude with other people in your home, you better get your anger under control, okay? There's a difference between speaking up against you know, politics and politicians. That's one thing, okay? But when you're in your home, you know, and around other Christians in the store or other people in the store, you know, we have to come to the conclusion that there's a difference between speaking up politically and being concerned about our country and the freedoms that we're losing every single day. We better stand up and we better try to save our country, okay? There's a difference between that, and I feel like people have a problem with that, like Christians, okay? Now, I'm not saying all Christians do, because there are so many Christians, conservatives, that are in this movement of trying to save our country from the downfall of it. I know I'm going off, I'm really going off, but thank you so much for tuning in and allowing me to just go off and just speak and just share. What I need to do really is sit down and make a list of what kind of videos I want to make. Other than this therapy for myself of sharing, let's call it that, so that I can place different videos. They'll still come up on YouTube, because I want to be true to myself and really post all my videos on YouTube, because I'm exposing myself. I'm trying to be real with you guys, okay? So that I can be naturally real. Even though you might think I'm crazy, stupid, phony, or just a jerk, you know, even though you know that I'm just full of it, okay? Praise God, okay? So what? I'm just sharing, okay? Why don't you get your thing going and you share, okay? And then you get back with me on that, okay? I love you. God bless you. And you can reach me over at newsandprayer.com. I have lots of pages that are being worked on continually. I have a project going that I really am out there on some things. I spread myself very thin. I have very little content, which you might call content from my own writings and stuff. Hopefully one day I'll be able to sit down and really concentrate and focus and write an article and write some stuff. Right now, I'm just doing what I can do between working my job that pays the bills. I get no help from nobody, okay? You might think that I'm getting donations and advertisers, but I don't have anybody to do that right now. So if anybody wants to come on board and help me, and then eventually I'll be able to do what I'm trying to do better, maybe, hopefully, and also get better at speaking, etc. Anyway, God bless you, and you have a wonderful weekend. I'm praying for our country, our troops, and the situations that are daily popping up. What Obama calls phony distractions or whatever, he's, you know, wow, okay. That's just a shocker right there, that he would call these things that have been happening, the NSA, the AP, the Benghazi, Fast and Furious, how he just throws these things under the bus and just tries to get us distracted from them. But I praise God that yesterday Jake Trapper, I believe, from CNN had an article. Check it out, that apparently there were so many CIA operatives on the ground, 35 or so, it seems like, in Benghazi the day that happened a year ago, the terrible, tragic events that killed 4 Americans, that the Obama administration has been trying to throw under the bus and tried to distract us from it. But there was 35, apparently. Check it out at CNN, Jake Trapper. Lead story, I believe it's called. And that came out yesterday. What else? There's so much news going on and everything. There's a big terror alert around the world, I guess. And so anyway, God bless you, and I'm going to stop this video now and have a great weekend and week ahead. Okay, talk to you later.